Welcome back to another episode of The Banana Show. I'm your host, Anna Banana, and today we're going to talk about four Black women in history that you might not know about. Now, you might be wondering why I choose to talk about women instead of men. It's because we know a lot about what men has contributed to Black history, but we don't know a lot about what women has contributed to Black history and taking us where we are today. So I decided to do a spin on that. So next week, I'll talk about Black men in history that you might not know about. So today we're going to talk about four Black women in history that you might not know about. So stay tuned. Remember to like, subscribe, share this video to your friends and family. And also, if you're listening from Google Podcasts, Apple Podcasts, or anywhere you get a podcast, please like, share. You can't really comment unless you have Apple Podcasts, but like and share it so that my numbers can go up, you know, if you like the content. So I'm going to start my rambling and get into it. I have my book right here because I do remember all of the things that I write down. I remember some of it, but not everything. So I got my book right here. So we're going to go ahead and get into it. So for the first woman in history, we have Claudeet Colvin. Well, first of all, before I get in it, I want to tell you that this is American history and not necessarily Caribbean or Jamaican. I was trying to look for Caribbean and Jamaican history, but I just couldn't find anything. So I decided to just work with Black people in America. You know? So my Jamaican peeps might not know any of this information like myself here. So this should be interesting. So the first lady, or the first woman in history, is Claudeet Colvin. I think that's how, I hope I'm pronouncing her name correct, but it's Claudeet Colvin. And she was a 15 year old in her time who did not give up her seat 9 months before Rosa Parks. So the story went something like this. So the bus was full, you know, the white people sit at the front and the Black people sit closer to the back. So apparently the bus was full and a white person was standing and she was sitting closer to the back. So they wanted to tell her that she must get up and give the white person their seats because apparently the white people isn't supposed to be standing, or white man or whatever. So the other guy or the other person that was sitting beside her complied and gets up, but she refused to because she said she paid her bus fare and it's her constitutional right to have a seat. So what they did, they carried her to jail and locked her in her cell until her mother and her father come and bail her out, apparently. And she was the first Black woman to stand up for her rights before Rosa Parks, but apparently she didn't say anything because she is of darker complexion than Rosa Parks. And she's saying that, you know, they like Rosa Parks more and they probably would have taken, you know, the Ku Klux Klan or the racist people would have probably fined her and all of that. But, you know, she stand up for her rights. So she was the first person. And she did this in 1955. So that's Claudeet Colvin, the baddest. And the next person we have on the list is Bessie Coleman, which is the first person to fly an airplane, the first Black person, and also the first Native American to be a pilot, and the first woman, I'm assuming, to be a pilot. So, you know, being Black, being Native American, and being a woman, you're going to get a fight in being a pilot or being whatever you want to be, because apparently we're supposed to be housewife, having babies, and keeping the house and nothing else. So she wanted to be a pilot. So she had to go to France to study to become a pilot, which she did, and she did well. But, you know, the US still wasn't having it. So she came back. And she wasn't allowed to fly. And she was only allowed to fly as a stunt person to perform stunts. So when she finished her degree, that's the only thing she could do, fly stunt. Hold on. Yeah, she only could have fly stunt, and then she died doing what she loved because she died in 19, well, she died in 1926 doing a stunt, and she had an accident in the air, obviously. So yeah, she was the first woman, Native American, Black person to become a pilot. So that's number two. That's Bessie Coleman. Number three is Lyda Newman, born in 1895 in Hawaii. She invented the hairbrush that we now have today for our hair, black hair. So yeah, they don't know much about her past life or anything other than that she invented the hairbrush when she was 13, and it was patented when she was 13 for black hair. So she invented the hairbrush, and she made it cheaper. She made it cheaper for us to access, because back then they only had products and hair products for the white people. So you know how that go. That must have been rough, by the way, not knowing how to care for your hair back then, and you know, struggling with all of that. So yeah, she was a so Lyda Newman, born in 1895, Ohio, invented the hairbrush. Yeah, they don't know much about her past life or, you know, future, when she died or when she moved or all of that. Because she born in Ohio, but she moved to New York City. Yeah. Number four now is Mary Beatrice Davidson Kenner. That's a very long name. Miss Kenner, let's call her Miss Kenner, was born in May 17, 1912 to January 13, 2006. She invented a lot of things. She was the one who invented pads, apparently. She invented pants, she invented the toilet holder and many other hygienic things. That was really cool to know that, you know, a black person invented the pad and all of that. Because they had tampons back in the day, but it was considered indecent and unladylike to wear them. So when you had a period, you have to lose cloth and stay inside and all of that. So it wasn't patent until 30 years after, because they found out that the original company that was supposed to patent it found out that she was African American, and they decided that they wasn't going to do it. So you know, it never happened until 30 years after, but she invented sanitary napkin, toilet holder, and some other inventions. She have a lot of inventions under her belt, and but these things were invented in 1956 and in 1892. So yeah. Yeah. That's it for today. I hope I was able to, you know, regurgitate the information properly, because I'm easily distracted, and this was as simple as it is, it's hard for me to focus. So it was a bit of a challenge, especially in this time. So yeah, I try my best to convey the information in ways in which you would understand. So let us do a review before, you know, I close out. So the four women, because me closed my book long time, you know. Hold on. So yeah, the first book, not the first book. The first woman is Claudeet Colvin, who, you know, 9 months before she, wait, my dog is coming inside. Lee? Wait, guys, I'm going to let you meet my dog. Say hi. Hi. Lee. Hello. Hello, Lee. No. Yeah, so that's my dog, Lee. He wanted to interrupt. So the first lady is Claudette Colvin, who was the first one not to give up her seat. Then you have Bessie Coleman, who was the first to fly a plane and become a pilot. Then you have Lyda Newman, who invented the hairbrush. And you have Mary Beatrice, who invented sanitary napkins and tissue holders and other hygienic things. So I hope you enjoy this video. I hope you enjoy this episode. Remember to like, share, comment, and let me know, you know, share information of what you know. Let us have a good time. And I will see you in another episode. Oh, and thank you for coming. Thank you for taking the time out to listen to my content or consume my content. I really do appreciate it. And I appreciate it. And I will see you guys in another episode. Bye.